What's up, brother?
I'm Carter.
And I'm Jackson.
And your Franklin Central News for Tuesday, April 16th starts now.
Junior FCHS Junior Vincent Rubio has placed first in his division at the American Protege International Piano and String Competition. He will travel to New York City to perform in the winner's recital held at Carnegie Hall. Congratulations, Vincent.
Join Bring Change of Mind for an Earth Day Nature Walk from April 18th from 2:30 to 3:30. We will meet in room 521. We will reschedule to the 25th if there's poor weather. See you there.
Attention seniors, there will be an appointment graduation meeting this Friday, 4/19, from 1 o'clock to 1:30 p.m. in the auditorium. You do not want to miss this important meeting as we will cover everything graduation related. Please try your best to attend this meeting this Friday from 1 to 1:30 p.m. in the auditorium.
FCHS Garden Club is hosting a houseplant sale to help downsize the number of plants before losing a plant room due to construction next year. Come down to the gardening room across the hall from room 503 during CCR Monday, April 19th through May 24th. Most plants are generally $5. Buy some greenery to help brighten your day and help out the gardening club. Cash or check only. See Ms. Dowd, room 508, if you have any questions.
Ready for a mouth-watering meal that supports a great cause? Join us at City Barbecue, 7863 US 31 South on Wednesday, April 17th between 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. and make a difference. With every order you place, 20% will be donated to Franklin Central Orchestras. Don't miss out on this incredible opportunity to dine for a purpose.
Attention all juniors and seniors, be on the lookout for a mail with a link to nominate two individuals to represent your class in this year's prom corps. Nomination ballots will be active until the end of the day today.
Attention FC, the Key Club is hosting its annual Scrub-A-Dub donation drive through the 26th. Bring in new, unused personal hygiene products to your seventh period class and place them in the brown paper bag. The class with the most donations will win donuts. Your donations will directly benefit the Cancer Center at the St. Francis Hospital. Good luck, everyone.
The junior class presents Pret Prom. This is a chance for all of our adorable furry friends to shine. From dapper dogs to fancy felines, they'll strut their stuff and show off their unique personalities, with pet parents rallying behind their animal babies. The voting for Pet Prom is open and will close on the April 17th. We can't wait to see who gets crowned Pet Prom royalty.
World Cultures Club is sponsoring a henna tattoo booth fundraiser, which will take place at the Flashes Around the World on Friday, April 19th, during the booth part of the event from 7 to 9 p.m. Henna tattoo prices will range from $5 to $15, depending on the design you choose.
The World Cultures Club is excited to host the Franklin Central's Cultural Fair and Celebration. Flashes Around the World. The event will take place on Friday, April 19th from 6 to 9 p.m. From 6 to 7 p.m., cultural performances will take place in the auditorium. From 7 to 9, visit country booths outside the cafeteria in room 700. We invite students, staffs, and the community to attend this event.
Now will everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey everyone, I'm Evan Walls with FCTV. This month is Autism Acceptance Month, so us here at FC Media have partnered with Bring Change to Mind to bring you a little insight about what this month is about and what we can do to help.
As club president, it's also important to me that mental health and neurodivergent folk are able to feel seen and feel like they belong at the school. I really struggled feeling like I belonged, and I didn't really feel like I had a good group to belong to. So I just hope to be able to set up that kind of safe space with Bring Change to Mind.
There's some people out there who like go up to an autistic person and or they find out someone's autistic and they like treat them like a child, which is just very demeaning because they're a normal person living a normal life just like everyone else and they want to be treated as such.
There is always the stereotype of autistic people just being like, you know, four-year-old boys playing with trains and, you know, rocking back and forth and whatever else, when really that's just not the case. Just hard to even have a picture of someone with autism because it discredits everyone else's experience with autism to begin with.
One of the misconceptions that people have is that autistic people have like some sort of special ability that they just come with, which, I mean, it can be true, but it just isn't necessarily the case. And going around and asking autistic people if like they can show some trick is very inconsiderate, and we want to get rid of that.
From this point on, Grace and Gunjot begin to tell me how someone like me, who is not living with autism, can be helpful to somebody who is.
The biggest point I always say when people are asking about how to interact with someone with autism is to just communicate with them and ask them what they need. A lot of times, like, for example, me, I tend to sometimes go nonverbal. And for me, that means that it's just hard for me to really like form words, but I'm still able to communicate. It's just that I'm communicating differently, like through writing or through text messages or something like that. So the biggest problem really is just you need to not dance around the topic. Like, just be straight up. Ask, hey, as your friend, as your teacher, you know, whatever your relationship is, I want to know how I can help you, and be willing to listen and not judge what they might ask of you. So communication is just really important.
Before we ended our conversation, Grace also shared with me a few helpful resources. Other information can also be found online at bringchangetomind.com. Again, that's bringchange2mind.com. I'm Evan Walls with FCTV signing out.
In sports tonight, Bull Ridge Golf will go to New Pal, Unified Track will be at Greenwood, girls tennis, and baseball, and softball and track will all be at home tonight.
That's all we have for today.
Tune in tomorrow for more FCTV news.
And thanks for watching.